Hello and welcome to Ilagan Whiteboard Fridays, where we look at various tax and compliance related issues in a user-friendly fashion. Today we will look at how the discount on employee stock options, that is ESOP, how it is treated as per the tax. So very recently in one of the cases, the Income Tax Tribunal has given a ruling that whatever discount that we offer to employees when we issue ESOPs are allowed as a valid expense. What it means, so suppose you ESOPs, as all startup knows, is been very popular to actually retain the key employees and other stakeholders, including mentors, advisors or consultants. So we can issue ESOPs to them, and we generally offer them at either a face value or at a very nominal value, not even a face value. So suppose, as say 2 years down the line, if I am an ESOP holder and if I am exercise my options, so the prices of the companies are expected to be much higher, so the company actually incurs a loss there by offering ESOPs to the employees. So till now it was not very straightforward or clean to actually claim those losses from your income, but now with this ruling that has been made amply clear. So let's look at what exactly it means. So for example, Today, an employee joins a company and you offer him, say, about a 4-year vesting period. So every year on year or quarter on quarter, whatever vesting you have agreed on. So when the employee works for that period, those stocks keep accumulated to his account. So actually we offer them options and not exactly the stocks. So the options can actually be exercised by the employee as soon as they get vested. Or he can actually defer it by some more time whenever, typically many employees defer it till the end of the complete vesting schedule, or whenever if they are quitting the company, at that time they exercise the option. Now, say for example, let's say there is a 4-year vesting schedule, so every year about 25% of the stocks get vested. On the date of grant, for example, today when you are actually granting the stocks to the employees, the value of the stocks were expected to be 100 rupees, the current market rate, what you can say, or the fair valuation of the company. Now, when you offered it actually to the employees, maybe at say 1 rupee or 2 rupees or whatever amount. So say 1 rupee if you have offered it, so 99 rupees is what you are actually incurring as an expense as on the ESOP, or the loss on ESOP. So this 99 rupees per share can now be claimed as an expense. Now it does happens that the employee actually does not exercises his option. So what you will do at the end of the financial year, now you have to file your return. So you say how much stocks has already been vested, not the ones that has committed. So for example, all your employees put together, about 1,000 stocks has been vested, which employees are eligible to exercise at any point of time. So 99 into 1,000, 99,000 is the loss that you have been looking at. So you can book that as a valid loss, you can reduce your income by that amount and then pay the taxes accordingly. Now, adjustment is possible with the actual event. That means, say 99,000 is what you 99,000 is the loss that you booked as on date, but after 6 months, when the stocks actually got vested, so that time, say the rate of the company stocks were 150 rupees. Now you had actually accumulated only 99, and now the loss is actually coming to about 149 rupees. So about 50 rupees extra what you are incurring loss, you can rebook that as again a regular expense and reduce your income in that particular year. In the case if your expense goes down, say for example the stock prices goes to 80 rupees, in that case 79 is the loss that you are actually incurring. So you will add 20 rupees back to your income in that particular year. So that's what is called adjustment possible with the actual event. Now vesting schedule, I have already said, you can book the expenses, because we generally in India follow a mercantile law where any income or expense is booked on the time in which it is actually deemed to be incurred or whatever it is. So you can book that 99 rupees as your loss for every year until the time when the actual event happens, and in case if the employee leaves or some stock get lapses, so then you don't have to book it. So mind it, you can only book expense for the stocks that has got vested, not for what has been committed. So that is very important. Now the bigger question is how to arrive at those valuation. Now for a publicly listed companies it is fairly simple, whatever is the market rate on a particular day, you can take that as the basis and then do the calculation. But for startups this is actually a important thing, because when you are a privately held company, you don't know what exactly is the true value or the fair value. So in that case it is highly recommended that you take the help of some expert who can actually help you arrive at a fair value. Remember, it should be a value which should be justifiable to the tax authorities with proper valuation reports and all. So you can either take the help of a third party or an expert to arrive at that. You can even use, if you have raised some money from any angels or VCs or anything, you can take that, some of those values also as benchmark at arriving at those valuation. But important point is, if you don't arrive at the right valuation, the market valuation, then the expenses could vary a lot. So it is important to take care of this aspect. So do that, and if there is a question, then you can always present your case with this was the basis of valuation on which you have arrived, and then they should be accepting it if it is a fair value. It's the right methods and systems that you have used to arrive at it. How it could affect startups? So startups are generally known for being cash crunch and also to sell their dreams. So now it gives you a higher flexibility to actually give much more ESOPs to the employees and try to retain some of the key employees who you think could be crucial for the startup. That is one. Secondly, certainly ESOP, as the startup ecosystem is maturing, earlier ESOPs were not valued in a great fashion in India, but with a recent lot of exits that the companies have made and where people have actually made fantastic money, now a lot of employees and key members are looking at ESOP as a key tool to get rewarded as the company grows, so to get associated with the companies and to grow. So the ESOP is catching momentum again, and on top of it, now the government is also supporting you, whatever loss you incur, so on issuing ESOPs at a discounted price, you can actually claim that as an expense and save some taxes there. So that really helps a lot. So these are about 2-3 major points how startups can get impacted with the new ruling on the discounted ESOP that has recently come. That's it on eLagaan Whiteboard Friday today. Feel free to drop us an email at support@eLagaan.com or check out our knowledge base at eLagaan.com/KB. Thank you.